Welcome to Electron Line, and here we're going to talk about what we call the order of the reaction, or the reaction order. So what is the reaction order? Well, going back a little bit, again, whenever a reaction occurs, we know that the reaction, the rate of the reaction, which is represented by the slope of this line, will be proportional to the concentration of the reactants. So the more reactants you have in your solution, the faster the reaction will take place. And as the reactants are being consumed, the reaction will slow down. But then we realize that there's a dependency on the concentration of the reaction. Sometimes that dependency is not linear. Sometimes that dependency is in the order of the square of the concentration of the reactions, or the cube of the concentration of the reactions. So that's where the term order of the reaction, or reaction order, comes from. So let's read the definition here. It says, sometimes the concentration of reactants will influence the reaction proportional to the square or the cube of their concentration. Sometimes it's even to the concentration to the 1.5 power or 2.4 power. Sometimes it's not even like the square or the cube. It can even be something other than an integer number. But whatever that is known as the order of the reaction. And of course, if there's more than one reactant, we have to add the orders together, one for each reactant. So for example, let's say we have the reaction A plus 3B plus 2C produces some products. Now A, B, and C are some sort of molecule or some sort of atom. 1, 3, and 2, I didn't write the 1 here, but the coefficients here, of course, represent the number of moles you have to have in relation to everything else. Now it turns out that the order is not related to these coefficients in front of the reactants. For example, the coefficients simply represent how many moles you need of each reactant, how many atoms you need of each reactant, and that's not necessarily, and quite often, not remotely related to the order. So how do we determine the orders? Well, most of the time it's done experimentally, and in some future videos I will show you how we do that. But right now, let's say that we experimentally determined that the order of this reaction was that the rate is proportional to the concentration of A to the first power, the concentration of B to the second power, and it's not related or not dependent on the concentration of C. So that's why we don't have the C there. So therefore we can say that this reaction is a third order, because we have the 1 for the concentration of A, we have 2 for the concentration of B, and we have 0 for concentration of C. So 1 plus 2 plus 0 gives us 3. So it's the order 3. Now, what does that really mean? Well, since we have a first order in A, that means that the rate is directly proportional to A. With other words, if you double A, then you'll have twice the rate of the reaction. If you triple A, you'll have 3 times the rate of the reaction. Also, here we have B being the second order in B. That means if you double the concentration of B, the reaction will be 4 times as fast. If you triple the concentration of B, it'll be 9 times as fast, and so forth. In other words, the rate of the reaction is proportional to the concentration of B squared. And of course, since they're both there, we then say that the order of this reaction is 1 plus 2, 0 for C, a total of 3 for this particular reaction. Zero order simply means C does not affect the reaction, as long as, of course, you have enough quantity of C not to inhibit the reaction to take place, because once you run out of C, of course, the reaction will not continue. So again, what do we say then? If A, or if the concentration, the brackets here simply mean if the concentration of A doubles, and if it's an aqueous solution, of course, then we're talking about moles per liter. If the concentration of A doubles, what happens? Well, since it's a first order in A, that means that the reaction rate doubles. And now again, quick quiz. What if the concentration of B doubles? Well, since it's a second order of B, that means if B doubles, we'll have 4 times the rate, so the reaction rate quadruples. So it'll be 4 times as fast, only 2 times as fast for A. So if the concentration of A doubles, the reaction is twice as fast. If the concentration of B doubles, then the reaction will be 4 times as fast. So that's what we mean by the order. And yes, we have to figure out what those orders are experimentally. You cannot simply look at the equation and say, oh, I know what the order is. You have to actually figure it out experimentally, because there's too many variables that control that factor. All right, so now at least we know what order is, and we'll show you in some future videos how we actually calculate, or, well, we have to calculate. We do some experiments, and from that we calculate what the orders are, and we'll show you how to do that.